So I'll start until they're ready. Our vision with Gjirafa is to build the internet economy in a region in Europe, the Balkans, that has been neglected vastly by major tech companies. With some exception, Facebook to a degree, others have been completely neglecting it. And it may seem to us, and I will try to prove it through either me talking or a presentation, that actually it's a blue ocean market. We have data, traction, users, and the backup from the investors that we can prove that we can build the next unicorn on that region. I think this pitch is just about, it is about Balkans. I think it's also about the, thank you. It's about the Gjirafa itself. So the region has, the perception of the region is a little bit worse than what it actually is in reality. The region is much bigger than it actually seems. The macroeconomic indicators do not represent the region fairly, and that's because half of the population here live abroad in very developed economies such as Switzerland and Germany and US and France, who actually help economically on the country. So for us, how we tackle this problem to solve it, we focus in two areas. One area is e-commerce. We own the leading provider of e-commerce marketplace, Gjirafa Mall, but we also own a Gjirafa 50, which is a retail e-commerce store. On the other side of the area, we focus on traditional offline to online businesses for something as simple as classified, vertical search, as well as video content. We even do business digitalization. Mind you, the businesses in this region don't even have a web presence. We went as far as we created our own street view, our own cameras, our own cars. We went and we digitalized the countries. And all of this is then connected with our in-house built Gjirafa ad network, which allows all the platforms to interconnect and actually monetize for future growth. I'm going to share with you two tractions. One from user perspective, which on average we have grown 3x year to year for the last 5 years. Also, our Gjirafa video OTT over-the-top media services is being used now for major media local players, filmmakers, producers, even TV channels. We are now even streaming TV channels 24/7, and just 2 months ago, for the very first time, we streamed old FIFA football, soccer games that happen. In terms of revenue traction, and I'm going to stop in here for a little bit, our revenue traction actually shows that the region not only is untouched, but actually has potential to grow exponentially across different spectrum and economies. The projection is on the green. This is the actual data, 2018. One projection at 7.2 million. It's our run rate as per September, as per this month's data. But this revenue is not only on the top. This revenue is equally distributed across all areas that we are focused. So our ad network in video, 3x 2017 first half versus 2018 first half. E-commerce, 3x, more than 3x, 2017 first half versus 2018 first half. And e-commerce, notable to note here, is it's growing across different business KPIs. It's not just the top sales value that is growing, but average order value is growing, return rate is growing. We are getting high performance on ratio of lifetime value to customer acquisition cost, which actually is a good indicator for our projection that we foresee in the future. So the question is, why us? Why do we want to go to this region? Well, we are a highly motivated team of entrepreneurs who are very, very hungry, and we can really execute. We can execute all these products because we can. When we decided to do e-commerce, from the day we decided to the first sale, it took us a month and a half. When we decided to do the prototype MVP of Gjirafa video streaming platform, which, by the way, is being licensed now in Europe on per fee basis, we did it in 2 months. And we also lead globally the Albanian language NLP. Remember, it allows us to connect all the products together. We are supported by a group of highly reputable investors from US and Czech Republic. Some of them you might know their faces, former managing directors of State Street, JP Morgan, Esther Dyson, and so forth. And we have been featured from TechCrunch to The Economist, everything in between. More details if you want to find out more. So what we're looking for today is, so far we have raised 5 million in Series A and seed. We're looking to raise 11 million. A good part of it we have already raised and received. We're looking for the rest of it. but we are interested in strategic partners and investors who can move as fast as we can. Our current cash flow, especially Q3, allows us to grow organically, but we don't want to lose the opportunity, and we look forward to grow faster. Ask me about the target IPO NASDAQ 2023 with $1 billion plus valuation. I'll be happy to give you as much answers as I can. Thank you for your attention, and I will be sitting there for any of you interested. Thank you.